All right, so we are going to talk about how Grimes is reshaping the future of AI-generated content. So let me set the stage for this one. Someone made AI-generated music around the artist Grimes, who was with Elon for a while. I believe they had a baby. Her take on it was, oh, this AI-generated content? Well, you know what? You can keep it up. Just give me 50% of the proceeds, and you know, I'm just going to use it to continue to expand my reach.
See, I look at it two different ways. If you're up and coming, you're not generating a lot of income, and I'm not saying this is Grimes. I don't think she has to worry. If she has a child with Elon Musk, I'm pretty sure she's financially taken care of. And I'm not saying that she can't do well on her own. I'm just saying, based on laws, I'm pretty sure Elon, being the world's richest man or second world's richest man, I don't know what rank he is at currently, I'm pretty sure he's providing for his own children. When you look at it, if you're an artist and you're not making that much money, sure, why wouldn't you want 50%? But on the flip side, Eric, if I was a really, really popular celebrity, like a Drake, a Weeknd, a Tom Cruise, or whoever it may be, it's not just about the money, it's about the quality. I wouldn't want stuff being put out there that doesn't match the quality of my brand, because I believe, and I have no data against this because we haven't seen enough of it, I believe it is going to hurt my future revenue potential because people will associate my name with crap then. And a great example of this is, dude, do you remember a lot of the celebrities, and I'm not going to name any because I don't want to pick on them and I respect them for, you know, business and just making money. But do you remember some of the celebrities back in the day that would just produce amazing movies? You know, a lot of them live in your neck of the woods. And now a lot of them just crank out movies and they'll just crank out whatever for the paycheck. And now when they create new movies, even though they used to have a big name, no one cares to see their movies because they'll crank out one or two a year, low quality. The storylines suck. The acting isn't great. Even though they're a great actor or actress, just the quality isn't there. And their brand is in essence tarnished from a revenue aspect if you're looking to create a high blockbuster quality movie.
That's a good point. Winnie the Pooh actually became open or creative commons or whatever it's called exactly, but people could do whatever they wanted with Winnie the Pooh. I remember seeing something where it's like a Winnie the Pooh horror movie, or maybe it's a Barney, but point being, that is affecting the brand, right?
Dude, people will start making sexual stuff and they'll go overboard with this Winnie the Pooh stuff. I bet you, right? I didn't know that Winnie the Pooh is creative commons, but you start doing that, people will do some freaky weird stuff and it'll start tarnishing the brand for kids.
If it's high quality stuff, if it passes a test, and then maybe there's some type of algorithm that says this passes the test, this makes my brand look good, then go ahead, let's do a 50-50. But if it doesn't pass certain criteria that I'm looking for, then that's a no-go and you need to take it down.
Yes, and I think what will happen in the long run, it'll be up to the artist or the creator, in which it's up to them if something stays or goes, just like right now. And if something stays and they want to leave it there, they should have a right to make money. Because it is their brand, their voice, their face, their image, their likeness, whatever you want to end up calling it.
Now, if you have any questions, leave a comment below. I'm here to answer them and help you out. If you enjoyed the video, like it, share it, tell people about it. Thank you very much.